give each other the right hand. Now that you have committed yourselves to each other in holy matrimony and have declared openly before God and in the presence of these Christian witnesses and has given each other the right hand as symbol thereof, I, as an ordained minister of the Church of Christ, pronounce you to be husband and wife in the name of God the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. What God has joined together, let no man separate. Amen. Please come up. With your witnesses, come all the way up. Let us pray. O Father, you heard the vows which Pomwene and Denda have made as they enter upon their wedded life. We bow in your presence and ask your blessing upon their marriage and upon the home they shall establish. May Jesus Christ be pleased to abide in their hearts and in their home. Unite their hearts in strong and holy love and trials of this world, their love may root deeper and grow stronger. Preserve them from evil that would destroy or diminish their happiness. Grant to both of them humility, kindness, patience, courage, and love not only for each other, but also for the children you will bless them with, for your church, family, neighbors, and the world at large. Keep their vision clear and their spirits pure. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, your dear Son, we pray. May the God of peace, who has started the good work in you, fulfill it on the day of Jesus Christ. Amen. You may rise and face the congregation. It is now my honor to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Nakapunda. You may now kiss the bride. I didn't see, I was reading the certificate, but never mind, I'll watch the video. You can have this. So that's the license. It has no expiry date, as we always say. Don't go and write any expiry date with your own pencil. Let me ask the congregation to rise so that we can conclude the first part. You may turn this side as well. Let us pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, receive now the benediction of the Lord. The Lord will bless you and keep you. The Lord will make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord will look upon you with mercy, favor, and love, and give to you his peace. In the name of God the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated. I think you should face the congregation. Let me now, I have concluded my part, give the director of ceremonies to give us the announcements. We are running behind time. We have a confirmation service starting. It was supposed to start at 12 already. So let's take time into considerations. Thank you.
Good afternoon. Can you hear me? Very good. Thank you very much. I would like to just take this opportunity really to thank Reverend Badwara for officiating over the union of the lovely couple, Mr. and Mrs. Nakapunda. My name is Andrew Kanime, and I'll be directing the rest of the program. We have a very, very brief program, more so especially because we're actually running behind schedule, and we're reminded we do have confirmees that need to get into the church for the next service. So we, in our program, we only have really two items, and that would be messages of congratulations and well wishes from the couple's parents, which will be done obviously by the parents. But before I extend the invitation to the parents to deliver their messages, I would just like to call upon Reverend Dr. Nakamela also to deliver a message of congratulations to the couple. Reverend Dr. Nakamela. Thank you very much, Reverend Dr. Nakamela, for those words of encouragement and wisdom. And as I said, I do not want to waste time. I would now like to call upon the bride's parents, Tate and Meme Shivute, to deliver their message.
Yeah. Good afternoon, dear congregation. Thank you, Director of Ceremonies. I have a short message to my children. We are going to share the message with Tate, so I have the first part. In life, there are five crowns. Denda, you know the crowns we have spoken about at your completion of high school, at your 25th birthday, Ishani Mbiono Karunga Ekuronge Kibira, Osisani Shonkara Mwenyo, Mo, the everlasting crown. I want you perhaps to go read it yourself. 1 Corinthians 9:25. Everlasting. But for you to hold that crown, you have to randura omausoga karunga. You have to obey. The crown for one who wins souls. Philippians 4:1, Thessalonians 2:9. What Pastor Nakamela said is true. It's what we know of this child. She's ever going out to reach out to others. And we are our prayer is that you continue to thank God for that crown that he has. Osishani wapewa kukarunga, mupandurango umsimane keno kumtanga esikukeshe. The crown of righteousness, what can I explain about that? 2 Timothy 4:8. The crown of glory, glorify him husband, through your family, your new family-in-law, it's your family. Praise God for that family.
And actually do what you want to do. But now you have to build a relationship and develop it and live together in harmony and in peace. It may sound simple, but it will take time. You will just find that there are certain little things that may interfere with that relationship, but learn to live with each other. Number two, learn to live with your in-laws. In Africa, we respect the family. Children, we say, are brought up by the village. And therefore, it is not just a question of you living with your parents, but it is also a question of you living with the broader clan. So, Ndenda, you have to build and develop a relationship with your in-laws. Pomwene's parents, his uncles, and so on, so that you can live in peace and in harmony. I would also say, Pomwene, you do the same. Build and develop a relationship with Ndenda's family, but in the end, it is really the two of you who will determine the borderlines, where, how this relationship should be managed. Thirdly, you will find occasions in your married life when there are irritating issues that may disturb you. Do not end up in a situation where Ndenda will say one, and then Pomwene will say two. Ndenda will say three, Pomwene will say four. That is not constructive. Learn to step back, take a breath, and then come back to the issue later and discuss it after you have cooled down. You may encounter many of these situations. It's only if you learn how to manage that you'll be able to live in peace and harmony. And then finally, I would just like to say that we wish you all the best in your marriage life. We want to see you happy. Pomwene, you came and asked for Ndenda's hand. We as parents have consented. We hope that you look after her, and of course, Ndenda, please look after Pomwene, so that you build a lasting relationship that will make you happy.
I would like to apologize. I know that we are still left with one item, which is really a delivery of the message on behalf of Pomwene's parents. I would really, really like to plea to the elders. It's 1 minute. If we can just ask Tate Kelly herself, last item Tate and Meme. Will not take long. 5 minutes. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kongwili Kwashiviro. Mfitawe Ongalo, Akulunive Ongalo Veliapa, Madimwe Shavali, Ovali Ombori Vetu, Ova Shiva Mushemu Romuma Fimana, Noimumbi Peiriapa. Ponele Dimole Tu, Tarakupandura Tate Kalungo Shitiwe Olunedu, Omendifiwaishi. Owe tu polu dalweli. Ndetela mene muhana na wavo. Telikwatana wa munyasha wavo. Fio vya petoko weli vaninge ovali homboli. Nova hombola nenapa. Hatu ngale la shike. Ohombo te ikalelele. Ohombo ine lao. Ya jombiri, ya johole, e didimi kilafano, ne dimi na fanepu. Ombu ine ininga ye virimbali, shashot bi ombu dopeifi. Neno tulimu fundula, mongeri nyo mahepu, nyundashu na kwa shivuti. Obi ombu dopeifi odo. Ndala mwidi dimike, ohombo eni kalelele. Ndeso, tali nkufa kumwe, ngaisha popu wa konfita hapa. Pomwene, I heard you telling her how you love her and how beautiful she is. I love you and beautiful does not end here. You have to keep on reminding her how beautiful she is and how truly you love her. You guys, you are lucky of today. You are 24/7 connected, no matter where you are. It's 2 things away. A voice message or a text message and say, I love you, mom. Come back home. Kunango mbrela kumbiona ndeterere. Yes. Mumbo nankalengo muno kakutukenya ko 12.5 kg. No mongwa ungota fing. Nekende linyalo kobo ngola kala kori. Atule kongua dikoshivelerwa. Opua kaeto tanguna onwa kautoka. Obo vimye tamosha mumbo. Shitivali kalango to putula matu wange. Wendango kofitura nkwenu emwe terakoshe. Ukajabo peife, obo man, gifts. Apitango penya posito pensho pa penya torande po katofi kenya kala ula, Blake Wilson. Pete pe kupandurango. Ya, hama ngava, nandihara tate shivute, aifame ko porifiku nyaka inde, difaingo bodi. Chashi umuno mikonda popa make pefa mati popeisi. Oponda kuja po mati wange. Pimbokali chali ile tu. Kawenda oke umpu.
T- Thank you very much. Thank you, elders, for your understanding. We've come to the end of the program. Two quick announcements. From here, the couple will proceed for a photo shoot at Avis, and they'll be expected at home at the Shivuta residence at 2:30, and not later than 1500 hours. And if we can please just observe time and move a little bit faster. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. The collections will be collected at the end, at the exit, that side. Thank you very much.
It's always been a mystery to me how two hearts can come together and love can last forever. But now that I have found you, I believe that a miracle has come. When God sends a perfect one, now gone are all my questions about why. And I've never been so sure of anything in my life. Oh, I wonder what God was thinking when he created you. I wonder if he knew everything I would need, because he made all my dreams come true. When God made you, he must have been thinking